Yo, friends, and welcome back to the Tuzzy Channel for more IU, and a very happy Fryu Day to you. Today we are fulfilling a couple of requests slash recommendations that I very much appreciate. Last week we watched By the Stream. Since then, Yuana Hive Mind has recommended a couple of songs that are of a similar sort of feeling. So our wonderful patron Nikki recommended Bad Day at the Love Poem concert, which is what we're going to be watching here today. And our wonderful community member Joseph recommended My Love by My Side on SBS, which is what we're going to be watching on Patreon today. So if you'd like to join in on that, the link is in the description. I really enjoy everything we've seen from Love Poem so far, so I'm looking forward to seeing this. This is the first time I will have heard either of these songs performed, so very much a first watch moment for me. Let's get into it. Gotcha.
Zombie. That's such a surprising, almost shocking move from the simple accompaniment to the full band. I read that she wrote this song in middle school, which makes me feel like an underachiever, and had a few different titles for it and eventually settled on Bad Day because that was the essence of the feeling, that it was one of those bad days where she didn't want to go home. She felt like a loner, kind of the struggle of, how do I put this, when you're in a particular mood, lyrics-wise, thinking about how she's talking about what's going on outside and the cold in her room and so the gloominess, how when you're in a particular mood, the world either goes one or two directions. The world seems to only reflect your mood because you are in such a headspace that you are picking out from the world all the things that are reflecting back to you. It's like when you learn a new word and suddenly you hear it everywhere, or the world feels jarringly different to how you feel. When you are deep inside a feeling like that, it's kind of one or the other. Either everything feels as you feel or everything feels wrong for appearing like the opposite of how you feel. The simple accompaniment at the beginning feels right, it's the wandering around the neighborhood and feeling like a loner and kind of drifting a little bit, not really wanting to go home, not really engaging and not really being connected to anything. And then the full band coming in is fairly shocking. And I suppose is the reflection of the question that she's asking of, will the icicles in her room melt and spring come again, or will it always be winter for her? Which then makes you wonder, is the band the representation of life and spring and something new pouring in and breathing warmth and energy into a space that has previously had none? Or is it the loud and desperate cry within her to stop living this bad day? That really took me by surprise. Coming in like that, it just felt so strong after something being so fragile and little. Especially, we've spoken before about Love Poem and about a couple of her concerts, how whoever is designing the costumes and the makeup for each moment chooses really well what looks are going to transition song to song and make sense with every song. So I know the song that she performed just before this was Knees. Knees being a song seeking comfort and seeking sleep for an insomniac like IU. And she is sitting in this comfortable, warm jumper and this soft cream color that is all at once innocence. It's the image of being wrapped in a blanket. And she has lyrics in this song about trying to snuggle down into her blankets more to stay warmer. It's giving off that sense of, one, winter with the whiteness, two, innocence and fragility as she appears sitting alone on the stage like that. And three, it being a knitted jumper, that's that warm blanket feel that makes sense for both Knees and for Bad Day. I know that she introduced this section as being the ballad section of the concert, so knowing what her ballads are like, that mix of comfort and fragility will make sense all the way through that section. And she's had that makeup on the entire concert. We've seen it with things like Blooming. With Blooming, the glittery things on her face seem fun and young, but there it looks like she has a teardrop hanging on her eye. And is also, because it's colourless, it reflects the icicles that she's singing about in the room. Very good costuming and makeup that they managed to transition and match whatever it is that she's singing. I can't get over that big band moment. That really felt like a slap. It really felt like a blow to the body. Sometimes bad days feel like a blow to the body, that you're going along and everything's kind of fine, and then out of nowhere you just have a bad day. You just have a really bad day, and for the life of you, you can't snap out of it, and it's so abrasive and feels like such an interruption to your life. It really pierces through whatever constant is typically your world, and then you have this one bad day and it's like a hit. I love looking at her ballads. I'm really attached to her ballads. I was actually talking yesterday when watching My Mister about IU's Inner Life, and her ability to exist within herself rather than externalize things, and what makes IU's ballads, as well as what's making her performance in My Mister so powerful, is the inner life. Even though this is a song that she wrote or has rehearsed a million times and sung it a million times, she's not doing a recitation. She's allowing the meaning of that song to come to her in the moment and be new and be fresh, and for it to be meaningful every time she sings it. She's living it as it appears, which is why they always hit as hard as they do. Well, that was a beautiful recommendation. Thank you. And it wasn't on my list yet because we have just so many things to get through, but I don't mind the little detour into some stuff. When things come up for us, you know, we should just indulge them. Thank you for joining me for another Freyu Day. Gamsahamnida, Sarangheyo, and I will see you soon for more. Annyeong!